Good evening. Wild winds, warm temperatures and dry ground. A catastrophic mix. Tonight a woman is dead and others are injured. Homes, cars and power lines all succumbing to fallen trees. Gusts reaching more than 100 kilometres an hour, fanning flames as spot fires popped up all over the state. Travellers on planes and trains also bearing the brunt of the wild weather.
We were warned of damaging winds. They were destructive and dangerous, bringing down tree after tree across the state. One fell onto a woman in a Camden front yard. She had to be rescued by firefighters and taken to hospital. At a holiday park in Moama near the Victorian border, it was deadly. A 63-year-old woman losing her life when a cabin was crushed by a toppled tree.
Emergency services found the cabin severely damaged.
Winds in Sydney near cyclonic, taking out power lines at Marsden Park and a ute at Abbotsbury.
The tree's actually split in the middle, and the fire brigade said they've got to get the whole thing down because the rest of it's going to come down.
A backyard shed in Kingsgrove didn't stand a chance, nor did this ageing bark, snapping in half and crashing through tiles.
The majority of jobs have related to fallen trees. We've seen roadways blocked, power lines disrupted, and a lot of incidents to property where branches have either broken through roofs or hit windows and damaged property and cars.
At Sydney Airport, it was slow on the way up, wobbly on the way down, with just one runway in operation. Dozens of flights cancelled to Melbourne and Brisbane. Services to Canberra still going, but not by plane, by bus. A wild westerly that spread all the way from the state's southern border, curving around Sydney up to the Hunter, combining with warm temperatures to ramp up the bushfire risk, total fire bans in place. Firefighters say they've seen a snap change in the landscape in recent weeks, from very wet to quite dry, which means it doesn't take much for fires to flare, which is exactly what we've seen here in Minchinbury today. Two grass fires burning out of control and shutting down the M4 as firefighters battled to stop it spreading to neighbouring businesses, workers evacuated.
If fires do start, they'll escalate quickly and potentially impact on people and properties.
Which is the case at Tamargo near Newcastle, an emergency warning in place, residents told to seek shelter as crews on the ground and in the air try to gain the upper hand and save homes. In Minchinbury, Annalise Bolt, Nine News. Trains have also been sent into chaos in our northwest. A tree fell onto overhead wires at 3 this afternoon in Normanhurst, bringing services to a standstill between Epping and Hornsby. The good news is, in just the last 20 minutes, power has been restored and trains are running to their usual timetable. There are also extra bus services, but it's been just another obstacle for commuters battling to get home after a day of disruptions right across Sydney. Pete?
Annalise, thank you. Let's bring in Amber now. Amber, where did we see the strongest winds?
Good evening to you, Pete. The strongest winds were in Sydney, the Southern Highlands, the South Coast and the Snowy Mountains. The highest gust was in Cabramurra near Cooma, reaching 109 kilometres an hour. High range near Mittagong saw a gust of 107, while in Sydney it was Camden that was the windiest suburb with a gust of 106 kilometres an hour. Gale-force westerlies impacting the entire Sydney Basin, the airport, Bankstown, the harbour, Kurnell, Penrith and Richmond, all reaching between 80 to 90 kilometres an hour. The winds will hang around tonight and early tomorrow as we wake up to a wintry blast. I'll tell you how cool it will be and when the winds will finally ease off a little later, Pete.
Amber, thank you.